Who will do, Tiddlypeeps? I'm Hubba Hubba, talking to you from Hoobland, and I'm about to send four of my favorite Hoobs down to Earth to find out all about you for my great Hoobopedia. Here they come! You know who the Hoobs are?
Iver!
Groot! And Tula!
We're Hoobs!
And they're ready to go. Now the wheels are turning, we cannot get learning all the things we want to know.
Yay!
Hubba Hubba's in Hoobland, and Roma's somewhere far away. Tourettes are singing.
We keep the engine spinning.
Hoop hoop hooray!
The Hoobophil is coming your way.
Ha ha!
Oh! Hey! Oh! The Hoobs are here, so you say.
Hoobs!
Groove spies with his hoobie eyes something the color pink. No. Come on, Iver, you have a go.
Hmm? Oh.
I know, I know. A little pink rag from your collection of your pink raggedy things.
Yes.
I won, I won.
Tula, can we stop playing now?
Oh, okay. What do you want to play instead?
Actually, I don't want to play anything.
Huh? Not anything?
No.
Are you all right, Iver?
I don't think so. I don't feel very hoobly-groobly.
Well, if you don't feel hoobly-groobly, what do you feel?
I feel very tired.
Oh.
And peculiar.
What sort of peculiar?
The sort of peculiar that stops me feeling hoobly-groobly. I don't feel like playing anything, or doing anything, or even thinking up a question for Hoob News.
Oh, dear! What are we going to do?
Well, I don't know, Tula. We need to ask someone.
But who, Groove? Who?
Who, 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 who?
Who? I feel so unhoobly-groobly.
Groove, you don't suppose that Iver's not feeling very well?
Not very well?
Yes. I've heard that sometimes Peeps and Tiddlypeeps are not very well. Maybe this not very well thing is happening to Iver.
Oh, come on, Tula. We never feel not very well in Hoobland, do we?
No. So I really don't know what to do. I mean, how can we help Iver feel better when he's not very well?
Hubba! Hubba! Hubba!
Hubba! How can we help Iver feel better when he's not very well? Now that is a fan-tabby Hoobie question.
I agree, Hubba Hubba. But do you think Hoobs everywhere would be interested in it?
Oh, certainly, Iver. After all, other Hoobs might visit the Peep Planet and feel not very well, and they'll need to know how to feel better.
But where do we start?
Let me see what I can find on Hoobnet. I've got some pictures that might help you. Have a look at these.
Ooh! Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo. What hoobly-groobly fun! Jumpy! They look well! Oh, look at... Oh, I don't see anyone looking not well here. Look at that! Oh, is it... Oh, ho, 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 ho. Look, a big hoople digger!
Those Peeps looked really well. Not like Iver at all.
Perhaps it was all that running around that made them feel so good.
I know. Iver, you run around like the Peeps we've just seen, and then you'll feel as good as they do.
OK, I'll try.
You can chase me if you like. Can't catch me!
Oh, dear.
Do you feel better, Iver?
No, I feel even worse. And now I'm all cold and shivery.
Oh, and what are we going to do?
I think running around was a very bad idea.
Yeah, and we still don't know what's wrong with him. What's making him feel this not very well?
Well, if we can find out what's wrong with him, then maybe we'll know how to make him feel better.
Hubba, Hubba, Hubba!
Thank goodness you're here, Hubba Hubba. We've tried to help Iver feel better.
But now he's even worse.
You could try asking the Tiddlypeeps. They'll know. and I'm sure they'll want to help. They all love Iver.
They do?
Of course they do, Iver. That's a great idea. Thanks, Hubba Hubba.
Come on, Groove. You drive and I'll go and see the Tiddlypeeps.
Yeah.
And I'll just stay here and shiver.
Seatbelt, Groove?
Yeah. We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps.
We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps. On the road we go. We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps.
They're smart. They're fun.
They know.
The Tiddlypeeps, the Tiddlypeeps help us find things out. They give us clues. They tell us news. That's what they're all about. If we need to know who, what, where, why, when, and how, we'll ask them, off we go.
Yoo-hoo!
We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps. On the road we go. We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps. They're smart, they're fun, they know.
And how they know.
Yoo-hoo! Hello, Tiddlypeeps.
Oh, it's Tina.
Do you want to do a hooby hello?
Yes.
Hoobledoo. So pleased to see you. I could really do with your help.
What's the matter?
My friend Iver isn't feeling very well. We've tried to make him feel better, but so far it hasn't worked.
What did he do?
Well, we got him to run round the Hoobmobile, but it only made him feel worse.
I'm not surprised. When you feel ill, you need to rest.
If you're really ill, sometimes you need to go to a doctor.
A doctor? What does a doctor do?
A doctor works out what's wrong with you and sometimes he gives you medicine.
Yes, but only if you really need it.
This is so interesting, but I don't know any Hooby doctors. I know! Maybe the Tiddlypeeps can tell me what's wrong with Iver. He's tired and he feels cold and shivery.
It sounds like he's got a cold.
A cold? Really?
If he's cold and shivery, you should wrap him up warm.
Does anything else happen when you've got a cold?
Yes, you sneeze like this.
Wow, that is amazing! Thanks, Tiddlypeeps, you've been really helpful. Now, I'd better go back and look after Iver. Hoobble doodle doo!
Hoobble doodle doo!
There. This big pink blanket from my collection of pink raggedy things will keep you nice and warm and you can have a lovely rest in the Hooby Pod.
Thank you, Groove. You're a really kind hoob.
Are you warm enough, Iver?
Yes, thank you, Tuna. I feel much better.
Groove, it's working. Iver feels better.
Yeah, and you will tell us if you want anything else, won't you, Iver?
Yes, thank you, Groove.
You just have a nice, long rest.
Thank you, Tuna.
He seems a bit better, Groove, but I'd still like to know what's wrong with him.
Yes.
Azoo!
You sneezed, Iver!
How hooby-groovy is that? Do it again!
Azoo!
Again!
Azoo!
Hey, Tula, this sneezing thing is hoobly-groobly.
Yes, and now we know what's wrong with him. He's got a cold.
I want to sneeze just like Iver. I want a cold.
Oh, no, you don't, Groove. You really don't feel well when you've got a cold.
No. I wonder where colds come from. Tula?
Well, Iver's cold must have come from somewhere.
Oh, goodness, Iver! That was a hoobacious sneeze! Now, how are you getting on with your question, Hoobs? Have you found out how to make Iver feel better?
Well, we found out that he needs to rest because he's got a cold, Hubba Hubba. But we were just trying to work out where the cold came from.
Ah, good idea. Now, as it happens, I found a Tiddlypeep story on Hoobnet that might just help.
In the land of the rosy noses, there lived lots and lots of rosy noses. There were big noses, long noses, pointy noses, and knobbly noses. Then there was poor small rosy nose, who didn't have anything special about his nose at all. Not only was his nose very small, but it was also very quiet. All the other noses honked, honk, or snorted, or even played a tune. Diddly-dee! One day, small Rosy Nose's nose started to tingle and twitch.
Oh!
He didn't know what was happening. And then...
Choo!
He sneezed. It was the biggest sneeze any of the other Rosy Noses had ever heard. They were very impressed. But small Rosy Nose was a little frightened. He had never sneezed before.
Don't worry, said Big Rosy Nose. You've just got a cold. You'll soon feel better.
But just then, Big Rosy Nose sneezed as well.
Achoo!
So did Pointy Rosy Nose.
Achoo!
Soon, all the Rosy Noses in the land of the Rosy Noses were sneezing.
Oh no, said Big Rosy Nose. We were too close to your sneezes, and now we've all caught your cold.
Achoo!
Achoo! Achoo!
But Small Rosy Nose's sneeze was the biggest by far.
Achoo!
From that day on, everyone agreed that although Small Rosy Nose's nose was small, it made more noise than all the other Rosy Noses put together.
So that's how you catch a cold, from sneezes!
You don't want to catch it. Believe me.
Oh, Tula, we better get out of the way when Iver sneezes or we'll catch his cold just like the Rosy Noses. Is it safe?
Hoobie-galoobie, I'm really sorry. I just can't keep the sneeze in.
There must be something we can find that Iver can sneeze into so he doesn't sneeze all over us.
Yeah, but what?
What?
Here's what, your little pink rag from your collection of small pink raggedy things.
Here you go.
Thank you.
That's better.
Yeah, I knew that little pink rag would come in useful. It's a Hoobie Groovy Hoobie Nose blanket.
Oh dear.
What's the matter, Iver?
I feel hot now, and I don't like it. And my throat.
Roma.
Oh, it's Roma. Maybe she'll have an idea about how we can make you feel better. Hoobledoop, Roma.
Hoobledoop, Hoobs. Today I'm reporting from a desert. A desert is a place that's covered in sand, and it's very, very hot.
Oh, just like Iver, Roma. He's very hot, but he's not in a desert.
No? Well, I am. And this desert is called the Sahara. And it's in Africa. You wouldn't believe how hot a desert can be, Hoobs. It's so hot, you could bake a Hoobie bun just by putting it on a rock.
You could bake a Hoobie bun on Iver's head, too.
Oh, poor Iver. He can't be feeling very hoobily-groobily.
No, he isn't. So how do you stay cool in the desert, Roma?
Well, when it's this hot, you always have to carry some water with you to keep you cool. Every time I get too hot, all I have to do is drink some of my water and I feel so much cooler. Oh, Hoobie bother! Oh, this is Roma Hoob reporting from a very hot desert. And can I have some more water, please?
Of course, Roma. We'll send you some more straight away.
Thank you, Tula. Hoobal toodle do. Phew!
Oh, Roma.
I'll ask Hubba Hubba to send us some more water from Hoobnet.
Now, Iver, if I get you some water, maybe you won't feel so hot, and it might help your sore throat.
But why am I hot? I'm not in the desert like Roma.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe the hotness is coming from your cold.
Oh. Thanks, Tula.
Right, that's sorted. Roma will be feeling cooler in no time.
And I'm feeling cooler already. It's made my throat feel better. Well, a little bit.
Poor Iver, you've caught a nasty cold. Now rest is best. Stay there. Do as you're told.
Snuggle in your cosy hoobie pod.
I'm feeling most peculiar, rather odd.
It'll soon be better, it won't get any worse.
Especially with me as your little hoobie nurse.
At first my head feels very hot, then suddenly I'm freezing.
Freezing.
Then out of the blue comes something new. I'm starting on the sneezing.
Sneezing.
At first you get an itchy nose. Then that itch just grows and grows.
Just look at Iver. Ooh, I'll be blowed. That little hoob is going to explode.
I'm getting in a stew. Oh, what's happening?
What a hoobie wheeze. I really loved that sneeze. But even though a sneeze is a hoobie groovy sound, and I want so badly to match it, the best thing to do when someone goes at you is to duck down quick, or you'll catch it.
So I'm sneezing in my little hoobie blanket, trying not to give my cold away.
We'll both take care of you, we'll be here to see you through.
A patient must be patient.
And with patience, then, that patient will be better in a day or two.
Yes, you'll be better in a day or two.
Are you feeling better, Iver?
A bit better, Groove, yes, but now I'm bored. Oh. Do you know, I've been resting for ages. I haven't got anything to do.
Hubba!
Hoobledoop, Hoobs! Are you still not feeling better, Iver?
A bit better, Hubba Hubba.
But now he's bored.
Maybe you should ask the Tiddlypeeps again, Tula. Tiddlypeeps will know what to do when someone who isn't very well is feeling bored.
You're right. Stay there, Iver. Groove is going to drive me to the Tiddlypeeps again.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps. On the road we go. We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps.
They're smart. They're fun.
They know.
The Tiddlypeeps, if we need to know who, what, where, why, when, and how, we'll ask them, off we go.
Oh.
We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps, on the road we go. We're off to see the Tiddlypeeps, they're smart, they're fun, they know.
I do hope you'll be able to help me. Iver's got a cold.
Oh, no, poor Iver.
We've got him to rest, we've kept him warm with blankets,
yep.
We've given him hoob loads of water to drink, and do you know what's wrong now?
No, what?
Iver is bored, so I've come to see you because I thought you might have some ideas for cheering him up.
I know, what about reading a story?
Oh, what a hoobacious idea, a storybook. Thank you so much. Is it an exciting story?
Yes. If Iver reads this, he won't be bored at all.
Oh, Hoobble Dooble Dooper! Iver loves stories. Has anyone any other ideas of how we can help Iver?
We can make him some get well cards.
Yeah!
Bless you.
Get well cards! Yes!
These are for me.
Yeah.
Tiddlypeeps. These are hoobly groobly. Iver will be so happy when he gets all of these. And he won't be bored at all.
Anyway, I'd better get back to him. Hoobal toodle doo!
Hoobal toodle doo!
Dear Iver, I hope you feel better soon. Oh, that's so nice. Oh, the Tiddlypeeps are so kind.
And look at this.
Oh, I'm going to read that just as soon as we've done Hoob News.
Are you well enough to do Hoob News?
Am I well enough to do Hoob News? Tula, I have never missed a Hoob News, and I never will.
Well, you're to get straight back into your hoopy pod afterwards, and I'll read your book to you.
Have you got your hoopy nose blanket?
Ring-a-ring a monkey, I'm feeling kind of funky. A jiggity beep, I make a silly sound.
That doesn't sound quite right to me.
It doesn't?
No, try this. Ring a ring of candles, we're wearing bright blue sandals. A wiggly bop, we all bounce around.
It's nice, but it's still not quite right.
Well, I like a good wiggly bop.
Ring a ring of roses, a pocket full of poses. A tissue, we all fall down.
Oh, that's good.
I want to try.
I knew you would.
Ring-a-ring-a-roses, a pocket full of poses. A tissue, we all fall down. A tissue, we all fall down.
Are you ready with your news, Hoobs? Ready to tell me everything you know about helping Iver to feel better?
We're ready, Hubba Hubba.
Hoobadoof-woop to all you Hoobs out there. Welcome to
Hoob News,
the new show for Hoobs
everywhere.
And today we've been asking the question:
how can we make Iver feel better when he's not very well? We wanted to find out what was wrong with Iver, so we went to see the Tiddlypeeps.
And the Tiddlypeeps told us that Iver should rest. They also said,
it sounds like he's got a cold.
We put Iver in a hoobie pod and gave him a special blanket from my collection of big pink raggedy things to keep him warm.
Iver started to sneeze.
Then we had a story about the rosy noses.
And that's when we found out that if you sneeze on other people, then they'll catch your cold.
So I gave Iver a hoobie nose blanket from my collection of small pink raggedy things.
But soon he complained that his throat felt sore and he started to feel hot. But Roma told us what to do about that.
Every time I get too hot, all I have to do is drink some of my water and I feel so much cooler.
Groove and I decided that we would look after Iver until he felt better. But then Iver started to feel bored, so off we went to the Tiddlypeeps for some more advice. The Tiddlypeeps made Iver some get well cards to cheer him up, and they gave us a book for him to read so he wouldn't be bored while he rested.
Bless you, Iver. And so it's thanks once again to Iver, Tula, Groove and Roma for giving Hoobs Everywhere a little peep into the world of peeps. And remember, wherever you are, don't catch a cold. Have a lovely day and hoobal toodle doo!
Hoobal toodle doo!
Holla holla in Hoobland and Roma somewhere far away. Motorettes are singing.
We keep the engine spinning.
Hoop, hoop, hooray!
The Hoobahoo is coming your way.
Oh! Yeah.